Alright everyone, Cody here. So I think today I'm going to be looking at the bees and wrapping things up so to prepare them for winter. See what we got in here. You know, they actually built out quite a lot. It's not as much as I would have liked, but yeah, they're got half this top box filled. So that's just giving a rough estimate. It's probably 50 pounds of honey in that box, which is just enough for them to survive the winter. And there's actually even a little bit up here still, which they're probably currently eating out and moving down into this lower box. So this is a good hive. And so I hate to do this to them, but this is some formic acid and honey mixed together. I'm just going to be putting this inside here, and that can mean the difference between them dying off due to mites and not. See, they'll eat that, spread it all around themselves, and it'll kill off the mites. Let's have a look at this hive here. Let's see. Oh yeah, they're not doing near as well, but there are quite a few more bees than I was expecting. Yeah, I'd say these guys, the biggest problem is they don't have enough food. First thing that's going to happen to them is they're going to run out of food and starve. So I might be able to feed them and get them to go through winter. Let's pull one of these frames out of here. They have any honey? They've got a little bit of honey. It's not a lot though. Okay, honey. Honey. Okay, yeah, they got enough that'd probably get them well into December. But it's not enough to make it through the entire winter. See, they've got part of this frame and these two amounts you can see right there. Not very much. So, you know, I think I am going to actually combine these with another hive. I think that'd be the best thing to do here. May as well put them with this hive right here. Okay, I think I'm going to go ahead and combine these hives. I got some paper there, got a queen excluder and a box, and so first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take this box and I'm going to shake the bees out of it down into the lower hive and take the frames and put them somewhere temporarily, and from there you guys will just have to watch. Shake off most of the bees into the other hive. Thick those combs are. Okay. Since I'm doing this, I think I'm going to take the formic acid and I'm going to move this down. There we go. Just drop it right in there. Excellent. I'm going to lay some paper across these guys to separate them from the other hive. There we go. Put this back on. You thought I was going to put the queen excluder between these, didn't you? Nope, that's not what queen excluder's for. Now you can probably guess what the queen excluder's for. See what I got up in here? The bees are working their way through the queen excluder down to those combs. The queen, however, will not be able to. If she's here, the queen is probably hanging out on the sides of the box. So I'm gonna have to keep pushing the bees down until there's few enough of them that I can find her. So the queen is right in here. No? She move? There she is, right there. There's the queen. I managed to find her. Let me put her in a little cage and that'll be pretty much done. There she is, locked inside of her little box. I'm not quite sure what to do with her right now, but at least I have her. Another dose of formic acid, and now I've got one big hive. Excellent. And I moved this bottom board over a little bit closer, and as you can see, the bees are kind of going into the hive, just like I want. Yeah, you know what? This hive is doing pretty darn good. They've got half a box of honey up here, and that down there appears to be crammed full of honey as well. So I think all I'm going to do with these guys is give them a little bit of formic acid and call them good for the winter. You know what? I think these bees are actually queenless. You can see I'm over here at the box style hive, and you don't really see the bees, but you can hear them roaring. And they were actually very aggressive. Until I got in here and give them a good smoking, they would come out and sting me even without the hive open. And usually when they're that aggressive, they don't have a queen. And that noise they're making is very, very similar to the no queen roar. And also looking down in there, I'm not seeing any brood at all of any stage. And this time of year, they should at least still have some capped brood. So yeah, makes me think that they don't have a queen. So you know what? There's one way to find out. And that's to put a queen in there. I happen to have a spare one that I don't know what else to do with. So I'm gonna stick her in there. I've got a candy plug. If they eat her out and she is not killed, then I know that they didn't have a queen, and now they do have a queen. If she gets killed while she's inside the cage, then she probably would have died anyway. So let me find a good spot to stick her, and I think that'll be good for these guys, besides the formic acid treatment, of course. I decided to put her right there. It's a little out of the way, but she should be warm enough that she'll survive for probably as long as needed in order to eat her out or either have the queen come and kill her. And the final piece of formic acid goes to the top bar hive. Yes, I really hope this formic acid does the job and knocks down the mite populations, because there are three things that kill bees. And that's, first of all, lack of food, foul brood, and mites. And lately, I think my main problems have been the mites. So this colony may be small, taking up only, you know, just a few frames here, but they've got a lot of honey packed away. I mean, look at this. That's nothing but honey. It's still not enough that I can harvest any, but I think it'll make them able to survive the winter just fine, especially if I knock down the mite populations with the formic acid there. After losing my bees several years in a row, I think it's time that I get on board and start actually being proactive against the mites. Obviously, the breeding the bees is not working. Possibly, that's just because the breeding population is just not big enough. I'm just not a big enough beekeeper yet to breed queens effectively. Oh well. As is things. So it looks like the bees are doing pretty good. They've more or less found their way into the other hive here. You see they're fanning it, telling the other bees where to go. Excellent. I think this operation was a success. And I think for the rest of this day, I'm gonna go around and pick up all this bee stuff. There's boxes all over the place that I've just kind of left out. I really shouldn't do that. Yeah, I'm gonna go put those up in the attic of the shed. Maybe I'll leave these fresh ones with a little bit of honey out for the bees to eat. And actually, this piece of honeycomb right here, I might actually send to one of my friends on, he's got a YouTube channel, Press Tube. I don't know if you've heard about it. I'll put links in the description and stuff. He asked me a while ago if I wanted something smashed with his hydraulic press and put to a video, so basically like a little collab. And the first thing that came to my mind was honeycomb. That'd be cool to watch being smushed, wouldn't it? So yeah, if you want to see this getting smashed with a hydraulic press and 500 tons of pressure, I'll put a link down in the description, and I'll probably publish this video when he publishes his. So yeah, hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you next time. Okay, they haven't had any smoke, but they don't appear to be flying up at me, so my guess is that that queen actually took and they've calmed down. Let's pull this open and see if there's a dead bee in the cage or not. Alright, there's a couple of live bees in there, but no dead bee. It means that the queen that I put in there actually survived. She's probably taken over this hive now. Well, good. I'm glad that worked out.